So here's the thing. I'm not a criminal, all right? I'm not a criminal at all. But if I was gonna be a criminal, I would think that one of the first rules of committing a crime is making sure you have a solid getaway plan. You gotta get away with the crime or it's not worth doing the damn crime. So I'm trying to figure out what this guy was thinking.
Oh yeah, you didn't tell me how that went. Did you?
When he decided to do whatever he did to get arrested. Looks to me like he would have a little bit of trouble getting away. Seems to me, maybe the straight and narrow is a good path for him. This vlog off with a little police activity over here. Who knows what's going on? We are on the Vegas Strip. What up? It's the Trooper. Got that shaken espresso action going. I think the light's broken. I'm on the list over there at Venetian, but I'm taking my sweet ass time getting in there because it feels so nice outside. It's unbelievable. 72 degrees. There's no real wind or anything like that. It just feels freaking perfect. Impressive. A few days ago, I realized that last night, Saturday night, 2 a.m., the clocks would go back, but I totally forgot about it until I woke up today and I was like, it's a little early. And then I realized, oh snap, the clocks went back. So I got to get up an hour earlier than normal today. You know, I was just across the street. I'm over here now. I was over there. Now I'm over here. When I was over there, it was time to dilly-dally. But now that I'm over here, it's time to get down to business. Or something like that. Got a little break from the game here. Funny story from the game. This dude tries to limp in, but they have like sort of like a light green color $2 chip here at the Venetian that should probably only be used for rake purposes, but they're in play all the time, all over the table. So you have $2 chips and $1 chips, $25 chips, which are usually green. That's the standard. are a deeper green. So this guy's playing in the game and he tries to limp in for $3. The game is 1-3. So he tosses out a green chip and a white chip. He thinks he calls three. Four people fold before anyone realizes that the guy raised, including himself. He has no idea that he raised. So the action is 26, and he makes it clear that that's not what he intended to do. Of course, that bet definitely stands. You can't take it back. And two people call. Like, one person calls, and then another person who limped in calls. I find that strange. Well, long story short, the first guy to call the 26 ends up check raising the flop, but he gets called. He checks, the player in the middle bets 45. The guy who made the mistake calls 45, and the first guy check raises to 140. So the player in the middle calls 95 more. The guy who made the mistake folded, and long story short, it was a jack-high flop. The check raiser had king-queen. King-queen high, all the way through to the river, and on the, I'm not sure if it was the turn or river, basically bluffs off his whole stack with king-high. I guess my point is, if you have king-queen, and you want to try to, play that hand when someone accidentally makes it 26. The only catch is that the guy who accidentally made it 26 could potentially be lying. Uh-oh, Lady Trooper's giving me good news about her, speaking of that, I didn't even speak of it yet. Lady Trooper just sent me good news about her sparkly pop making method. We made some progress. She made a major change in the way she makes the sparkly pops. And believe me, they're even better than they were before. And speaking of sparkly pops, got that new sparkly pop right here. Love it. Spiced Cranberry Jingle Sparkly Pop is the name. You got cranberry juice, you got orange peel infused into that, and then you got a little tiny touch of cinnamon, which you can't even really taste. Damn, good sparkly pop. Back to the point, I hate $2 chips. I hate $3 chips. I hate them. I think they have no business in the game. All right, back to the game. There was a time when I really did like Francesco's Pizza. That was sometime before COVID started. Wow, it's windy. I don't know if that wind is destroying the video, but I got a nice backdrop over here, so I'm not moving the damn camera, all right? Sunday night. Sunday, Sunday, Sunday. I gotta go home. I gotta edit the podcast. I won $215. Game was pretty decent. I liked the game tonight. I really liked it. You know, sometimes I come out and I say the game was really good, but I lost 400. And then people go, oh, the game was really good, huh? You lost 400. How can the game be so good if you lose 400? those are people who don't know what the hell they're talking about. There have been many, many, many times, though, when I say the opposite. Game wasn't that great, but I won, you know? And then tonight, it's like, okay, I won, and the game was good. People just hear what they want to hear. There are a lot of really stupid people out there who watch this vlog. A lot of really stupid people. Over 99% of you are really smart. I know that. I've met many, many of you. All right? There are a lot of people, though, who watch this vlog who are really dumb, who are uninformed, who are closed-minded. Stupid is really the word. I see it in the comments. I read the comments, and the comments say things that are so ridiculously untrue. I'm like, how can you possibly? Back to the point. Remember, if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button. Make sure you subscribe. Tell your friends about the videos and leave a comment down below. I'll see you next time.